Hello, I am Krishnamurthy Pammi. On ground, we come across bundle of project events, outcomes or risks. Using inference diagrams, we can understand how multiple things can influence each other. This way, using graphical tools, we can understand the influence of multiple items on each other and also cause and effect relationship. This way, we can take better decisions. Let us understand inference diagrams using a couple of examples. Our first example is on set of skilled resources. The moment we have set of skilled resources, the management tend to assign them to trouble projects because trouble projects eat away most of management's bandwidth. That's why they wanted to assign skilled staff to complex projects or troubled projects. Now, often the troubled projects lead to less return on investment. This is what history says. Also, they lead to less or medium customer satisfaction. The moment you see less or medium customer satisfaction, you tend to arrive at a conclusion to assign skilled staff on such projects. So it is like a circle. Skilled staff leading to troubled projects, leading to less return on investment, leading to less or medium customer satisfaction. Again, you are having a skilled staff. Again, they are assigned to troubled projects. So the circle goes on. So the inference diagram now showing graphically what comes first, how they are interrelated, how they are influencing each other, what is the source, what is the effect, and how the cause and effect are related, and what is the net outcome of these entities on overall project objectives. So, inference diagram is acting like a better decision-making tool because we are seeing what event is coming first, what event is coming next, and how they are related, and how they are impacting the overall project success. Let us take another example of inference diagram relating to risks. Now, whenever we want to start any engagement, we have a mix of skilled persons and low skilled persons. Most of the time, the management want to maximize the percentage of less skilled persons because they come at a low cost. The moment you have more percentage of low cost employees, they tend to provide incorrect project estimates because they are not rightly skilled. And the moment you have incorrect project estimates for project activities, you may end up with unfinished project activities. This unfinished project activities may again lead to cost overrun because these activities require high skilled persons, because less skilled persons can do certain activities beyond which you require the hand of skilled people. So the moment you position the skilled people or you take more time to complete a specific project activity than scheduled, you end up with cost overrun. The moment you have cost overrun, just by looking at this particular risk called cost overrun, you want to position low cost employees. So it's a circle. Low cost employees producing incorrect project estimates, leading to unfinished project activities, leading to cost overrun. Again, by looking at this particular risk, you wanted to position low cost employees on the project. Likewise, it is a chain. The moment you see all these risks in a diagrammatic way, in a graphical way, you know what is coming first, what is the cause, what is the effect, how the cause and effect are interrelated, what comes first, what comes next, and how they are contributing to the overall project outcomes. This is the beauty of inference diagram. So, inference diagram is a graphical representation of project events, entities, outcomes, or risks, showing what influences them on the time scale so that variables and outcomes can better be analyzed by understanding their relationship. So, we can as well provide probability and range estimate for each of the risks so that we can validate these probability and range estimates using the Monte Carlo S analysis
or sensitivity analysis using tornado diagram. This way, we can understand what is the key risk involved and what is the net outcome on the overall project objectives. So, inference diagram acts as a graphical aid to decision making under uncertainty. They provide the cause and effect relationship among the identified risks, project events, project resources, and other outcomes. So, simply put, inference diagram shows the cause and effect of multiple things. They provide what comes first, what comes next in a graphical timescale sequence. So, inference diagram are graphical aids to decision making under uncertainty.
I thank your interest to learn, and I look forward to add more value add sessions in future. Thank you.